KCRA 3 Kitchen right now. We are taking that traditional comfort food, mac and cheese, and this man right here, David Rowe from Renwood Winery, you're turning this into a lollipop.
That's right. Gourmet-style lollipops.
I love it. And it's also portion control.
Yes.
Just don't eat too many lollipops.
That's right. So you can make the small ones and the large ones.
Okay, let's get started. So first you do just traditional mac.
Traditional mac and elbow mac and cheese.
Okay, so you just make your macaroni.
Yes, 2 minutes in the hot water and cook it. Then you have a cheese sauce.
Okay.
Your flour, butter, milk.
Flour, butter, milk. Does it matter how much of each one?
It's a portion
thing. There's a little bit. Okay, we have the recipe on our website. And your favorite kind of cheese to use is?
My seaside cheddar.
Okay.
And then some, and I also love some gorgonzola to add to it.
Is there a cheese you don't recommend?
With mac and cheese, not necessarily. Really, you can use pretty much any cheese, personally speaking.
It's good
honestly,
to know.
I've tried a lot.
Okay.
As long as you have the sauce base thickened, you can add anything to it. Then what you do, you get just...
You mix the macaroni with the cheese and you put it in the thing overnight, right?
Right.
Okay.
Right. And it sets. You can see perfect solid. You can scoop out your balls with your ice cream scooper.
If you don't have overnight, how long do you need to wait? About 2 hours?
2 hours at least.
Okay. So you can use an ice cream scooper or a melon ball scooper?
Okay. Depends on the size you want.
All right.
Helps.
And then what? Actually do it for us so we can see how this works.
Okay.
I want to see how this works.
Right?
All right.
And here's the flour. Uh-huh. You dread it in the flour a little bit. Okay. Uh-huh. And then you go from the flour to the eggs.
Okay.
Dread it in the eggs, right? Make it coat it really well, and then you go from the eggs to the panko. Excuse
the breadcrumbs.
And
you prefer the panko.
I prefer the panko than the breadcrumbs. It seasons a little better. Mm-hmm. Then what you get your children or kids, and if you want to have a little more fun, get it and you roll it, and you have the perfect balls going
on. All right.
Look at that.
Okay.
Then here's the finished product. Then you go from there, and then you're going to go to the hot oil. And you start frying that little sucker.
How long does it need to fry? And it's already cooked inside. Well, I guess the outer crust is what you're cooking.
Right,
the
it's outer crust is what you're cooking. Also, the heat is, the temperature of the inside is important.
Okay.
So you really want to make sure that's there for you. And then what you do, you get your little nest here, and you kind of roll it in the oil as it fries along, and it turns a little brown color. The advantage is, what you're really looking for is that beautiful golden color, and as you see, it's come along. Once it gets to that
stage, toasty and yummy.
The cheese sometimes start to pop out of it. You know it's really finished.
Okay.
And there you go. You want to have a paper towel to sit, let the oil all seep through in that paper towel so it dries out.
Okay. Wow, you really got to watch these.
Finish that right.
And then on average, how long do you think they'll take to cook, on average? A couple of minutes a piece, or just 30 seconds?
No, 30, 40 seconds.
All right.
And then you get a little sauce sometimes. This is my favorite sauce.
What is it?
Chili hot sauce, okay? This is really, really lovely. So basically, when you take that...
And then, sorry, no. And then I'm just going to get these out. I like that you've used a votive candle holder there to display them. That's great when you're entertaining.
It's a great hors d'oeuvres appetizer thing to entertain with.
And then you just put the lollipop stick in.
Right, right. And there you go. You can set it on a plate if you like. If you're at home with your kids and they can do it for you, really fun.
I like it.
And when you go to eat... Dip in a little bit.
And then you eat. David Rowe from Renwood Winery, thanks for being here. We sure appreciate
it.
We have got this recipe, all this information at KCRA.com, the On TV tab, and you'll see it in the As Seen On section. Deirdre, over to you.